Hey everyone! This time we will take a look at the iconic full-frame mirrorless. Meet first-generation Sony A7. I'm very curious to see how it performs from today's perspective, after 6 years from its announcement. Also, $800 for a brand new camera with a full-frame sensor seems very convincing. I would be very grateful if you subscribe and share this video. This helps me to grow and make more and more camera comparisons and reviews for you guys. Besides, you will sometimes get opportunity to vote which camera will be next on the list. Thanks! Let's start by mentioning key specs of Sony A7. It has 24-megapixel full-frame CMOS sensor, 117-point autofocus system, records 1080p videos up to 60 frames per second. Body composed of magnesium alloy and plastic leaves pretty much no complaints. Actually, at first I thought it was all made from metal instead, because of slight glossy metallic-like finish. But use of composite doesn't matter since everything is really well put together and whole construction gives impression of solidity and high quality. In addition, it's weather sealed. Camera is ergonomically friendly, aside from two things: weird shutter button placement and grip, which is too small. That said, I think it's still comfortable to use, especially after using those heavy 1 kg full-frame DSLRs. Half a kilogram of weight from a full-frame camera is always welcome. 3-inch LCD panel on the back lacks full articulation, but I don't mind that, since video recording capabilities of this camera are not so impressive either. In short, screen is nothing more than just usable. It unfortunately has too much reflections, poor contrast and dull colors. Quality of 2.4 million dot OLED viewfinder probably made some bigger impression back in 2013. But nowadays things get different, especially for me, right after using Panasonic's FZ300 EVF. In comparison, one in Sony definitely lacks vision, sharpness and contrast, but don't get me wrong, it's still pretty decent viewfinder overall. Either way, I still hold the position that optical viewfinders have some edge. With a DSLR, camera can always be turned on and ready for an instant action. With a mirrorless, you are doomed to the screens, which drain battery pretty quick and rely on the software speed, which is especially the case with the Sony A7. Unfortunately, operating speed is not the fastest. Turning camera on, switching to viewfinder, focusing and taking picture, it all takes some time for it to process. Aside from that, user interface is like in any other Sony camera. Pretty easy to use and menu works good. I didn't experience any problem with autofocus. It's generally fast and accurate, although performance in low light is slightly worse than in DSLRs. But I already said and showed that in my Sony A6500 review. If you want to check it out, link will be in the description. Moving into the most important part, image quality. Most of the times, photos come out balanced, but despite having good dynamic range, Sony A7's exposure control have tendency to sometimes produce darker, little bit underexposed pictures. Color accuracy also seems good, but I think there are not so many color variations and richness like in my favorite Nikon D810 that I've tested a couple of months ago. There is a good amount of details and sharpness. In the crop you can truly appreciate great depth and texture of photographed objects, which I thought I was missing in the photo quality of Canon 5D Mark III in that review. Well, maybe I would like to see slightly more clarity and sharpness, but I'm not sure on that since I was only limited to one lens in my testing period. Personally, I would like more resolution also, but I can't complain since A7R with 36-megapixel sensor is meant for that. As with all full frame, you will get that beautiful depth of field, and this one is no exception. Low light performance is like you would expect from camera in this class. Great. Hardly any noise up to ISO 800, and below it's still going really strong. Although I don't like Sony's noise reduction algorithm in JPEGs, it produces too many artifacts, losing a lot of details. In terms of movie quality, this aspect is very outdated. 1080p videos looks blurry, having mediocre amount of details and by far not the best sharpness. I wouldn't recommend getting this camera for video recording to anyone. On the other hand, as an extra feature, it's nice to have. Full frame depth of field, decent colors and good low light performance might give you some worthy shots. In summary, Sony A7 is a fantastic choice for both amateur and professional photographers. 500 bucks for used or 800 bucks for a brand new full-frame camera with performance like this is a deal that's just hard to argue with. That said, if you would like to spend a little bit extra to have more resolution, I would suggest Sony A7 R. There are also used DSLR alternatives like Nikon D800 or more comparable Nikon D610. If you consider something different. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to write a comment and rate this video. See you later.